Hello! Today I want to talk about Silesian with all its facets. Why this topic? Well, it kind of personally affects me. Silesian is by itself not an official language, but in my opinion it is a very good example for how languages mix. There are basically two versions of Silesian, German and Polish Silesian. First, I'm going to talk about its history. History. To understand why there are two Silesian dialects, or languages, if you ask the natives, you need to know the history. Silesia is one of the most central regions in Europe. It goes from Görlitz to Katowice. Many big people are from there, but that's something for another video. In the early Middle Ages, Silesia was either part of Bohemia or Poland. During the Mongol invasion, 4/5 of the population were killed. The land was already sparsely populated, and the Piasts, the ruling dynasty of Silesia, needed German colonists to populate the land. In the year 1348, Silesia became part of the Holy Roman Empire. In 742, Prussia took over most of Silesia from the Austrians. In the 19th century, the population in Silesia was very diverse. In Lower Silesia, there was a majority of Germans, and in Upper Silesia, many people were bilingual, speaking German and Slavic Silesian. After the First and Second World War, most of Silesia became part of Poland, except for the part on the left side of the Oder. Most Germans were forced to move to West or East Germany from Silesia. German Silesian. When the Germans moved to Poland, they took their dialects with them. Many of them were from Franconia, Saxony, Thuringia, Hesse, Lower Austria and others. You see, mainly Central and South German. It is no wonder that German Silesian, also called Schlesisch, is very similar to Central and Southern German dialects. For example, the Bavarian word for bread roll is Semmel, and in Silesian it's the same. After the forced immigration and the distribution and separation of the German Silesians, the language kind of died out. There are still some communities and even literature in Silesian, but it will probably die out soon because most of the speakers are pretty old. Polish Silesian. Well, what is Polish Silesian? The only real Silesia, or Śląski, is left in Upper Silesia. Upper Silesia was historically a region between big countries, as you know. It was part of Bohemia, and Silesia is sometimes similar to Czech. It was and is still part of Poland, thus it is a Polish dialect, and it was historically a German region, thus a major German influence. How many still speak it? It's not known, to be honest. In 2011, 509,000 people said that they speak Silesian. But do they still? Well, probably so. I would say maybe 400,000 people can still speak it. Silesian does not have a useful official status in Poland, though there are many organizations to promote Silesian. I hope it will get its rightfully deserved status as a regional language or dialect, and it should be taught in schools. In the following, I will only talk about the Polish Silesian. Many Silesians don't even know whether they speak Polish or German Silesian in Upper Silesia. It became a really funny mixture. Grammar. In general, Silesian grammar is similar to the one of Polish. A major difference is, for example, the question syntax. In Silesian, there is inversion, unlike in Polish. When a Pole says, Czy ty jesteś w domu? A Silesian would say, Jesteś ty w chałupie? Vocabulary or słownictwo. Silesian is a Polish-based dialect. It has major Germanisms and words from Czech and even Slovakian. Germanisms are everywhere, like wuscht, wurst, Wasserwoga, Wasserwaage, maras, morast. I have to say though that these Germanisms are closer to German Silesian than standard German. An example for Czech words is, for example, pozor, meaning attention. There are no general numbers for how many words are from which region, but you can roughly say that 10% of the words are Germanisms. writing system or Schreibunek. Because of pronunciation that differs from Polish, Silesian does not adapt the same writing system. There are many different proposed writing systems. The most approved one is Schlabikozowy Schreibunek. It uses 35 Buchstabe or letters. These are the following. Many organizations use this alphabet and also parts of the Silesian Wikipedia are written in it. One of the first alphabets is the Steuer alphabet by Felix Steuer, made in the early 20th century. Based on it, there is a phonetic Silesian alphabet made in 2006, which only uses 32 letters and so uses the least amount of letters. But it happens that it isn't very popular because it reassembles the Czech alphabet too much. Nonetheless, it is widely used on the Silesian Wikipedia. It uses these letters. These are phonetically consistent, but again not popular under some Silesian speakers. Phonetics. There, these consonants are in Silesian Spogorski. As you can see, typical for Slavic languages, there are many diphthongs like ts, tz, ch, dz, ch, and dz. And there are these vocals or Samogorski. A, E, E, I, O, O, U, I. Reassembled as these letters. Here you have the Lord's Prayer in Silesian in the Steuer spelling. Ojcze nasz, kierujesz w niebie. Być poświęcone miano Twoje. Przyjdź królestwo Twoje. Być wola Twoja. Jako w niebie, tak też na ziemi. Chleb nasz każdodzienny daj nam dzisiaj. A odpuść nam nasze winy, jako a my odpuszczamy naszym winnikom. A nie wódź nas na pokuszenie, ale zbaw nas ode złego. Amen. I know it's not perfect, but I tried my best. Now to the important question. Is Silesian a language? Linguistically speaking, no. Almost all linguists say that it is not a language and only a Polish dialect. I also agree with that. But there's more to this question. Silesian seeks political recognition and should be recognized as a local dialect. Even dialects are worth keeping. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to my channel. Goodbye and do widzenia!